since I think you go back to, was it January 18th, 2020, the UFC 246 McGregor Cowboy in Las Vegas. This was like pinnacle of UFC pre-COVID up until now. You look at every UFC fight card from 2020, from UFC 246 McGregor versus Cowboy, up until UFC Fight Night Thompson versus Neil that just ended. I mean, you could say, what was the fight card the UFC did, it was just amazing. Well, I have to say the UFC 246 McGregor versus Cowboy, because that was McGregor's fight back. He fought Cowboy, Don Cowboy Cerrone, which that fight card itself was just amazing. Then you go up and down, up the list, from Blaydes versus Dos Santos, Jones versus Reyes, Arizona versus Bohovic, two. Felder versus Hooker, Benavidez versus Figueroa, Adesanya versus Romero, Lee versus Oliveira, and from March 21st to May 2nd, there was like five fights that were canceled. That was when COVID, at the time, was really picking up a lot of steam. And then from May 9th, they went to Jacksonville, Florida for 3 days, which that fight card itself, that Ferguson Gagey, that was, you know, that was the fight that of Henry Cejudo's UFC career when he was the bantamweight champion, and then suddenly Al Mohr, Henry Cejudo announces that he's walking away, he's retiring. I was just like, wow. Kind of never saw that one coming. And then from May 30th, when Woodley took on Burns, which that was big fight for both guys, because Tyron Woodley, former champion, Gilbert Burns, who was his up-and-comer welterweight. Then after that, so they just kept pumping out fights one by one. Once UFC was in Jacksonville back in May, they went back to Vegas, and they went overseas, Abu Dhabi, to the Flash Forum for like 5 nights, and then back in Vegas, and then back to Abu Dhabi.